We are now ready to classify proteins into family using hidden Markov models. Let's assume that we are given multiple alignment of already known members of the protein family and that we have constructed HMM based on this family. And now a new protein comes in and we want to decide whether it belongs to the given protein family. The easiest thing to do is simply apply the Turby algorithm to find an optimal hidden path and decide whether this protein belongs to a family depending on the probability threshold for this protein. So that's what's shown on this slide. And if this probabilistic threshold satisfied, then we classify protein as belonging to this family and extend the alignment of proteins in this family as shown in this slide. So to do this classification, we need to construct the Turby graph for the given HMM diagram. Please note that we have not discussed yet how to construct the Turby graph for an HMM diagram. For example, how many rows this Turby graph will have? Well, as before, the number of rows in the Turby graph should be equal to the number of states in this HMM diagram. So, large number of rows. And here I showed the Turby graph, and I took a liberty to assign every single column to every state HMM is passing through. Does it make sense? So, the number of columns in the Turby graph shown here equal to the number of visited states. There is one problem with this Turby graph. We don't know in advance what will be the number of visited states when we look at the newly sequenced protein. And therefore, it's not even clear how to construct this graph. For example, in this case, it has two deletion states, but how do we know this before we constructed the HMM, the Turby graph? And therefore, we should actually try to think about how to construct the Turby graph based with the number of columns based on the number of emitted symbols, something that we know rather than the number of visited states, something that we don't know in the case of silent states such as deletion states. And therefore, by definition, the number of columns in the Turby graph should be equal to the number of emitted symbols, which means it should be smaller than the number of columns in this erroneously constructed Turby graph. But here is the correctly constructed Turby graph. Every time we move to the deletion state and do not emit the symbol, we actually transform the edge into a vertical edge within the same column. In this case, the number of columns in the Turby graph equal to the number of emitted symbol, and the Turby graph then is well defined. The only thing we need to add is the zero column that contains only silent states for technical details. So we just reduced the problem of alignment with the profile HMM to the following problem: align a new sequence to a family of aligned sequences using a profile HMM. The input is a multiply alignment, a string text, a threshold theta describing maximum fraction of insertions per column, and a pseudo count sigma. An output is an optimal hidden path emitting text in the profile HMM, denoted HMM alignment theta sigma. Let's take a look at the hidden path constructed in the HMM diagram. And of course, this hidden path corresponds to a path in the usual alignment graph that we considered before. The question then arises, we just described a rather complex decoding algorithm for constructing the hidden paths in the HMM, but wouldn't it be easier to just construct the same alignment path using the traditional alignment technique? Or in other words, have I wasted your time? Indeed, the recurrence for the Turby algorithm is very similar to the recurrence for the traditional sequence alignment. For the Turby algorithm, the score at the node equal to the maximum of 3 scored of the preceding state. For the alignment, again, the score of the node equal to the maximum of 3 scores of its predecessor. So it indeed looks like I wasted your time. However, notice that the choice of alignment path is now based on varying transition and emission probabilities between different columns. And therefore, this individual scoring parameter allows us to detect subtle similarities using HMM, similarities that the traditional sequence alignment often misses.